Hey, welcome back to Diablo Garage. So today we're going to be switching gears. The other part of my builds that I do, because I do work on hot rods, classic cars, is off-road. I love Jeeps, grew up with them, but also dirt bikes, a little bit of ATV, starting to get into that. Anyways, today we're going to be doing a walk around on the Jeep, not to mention the lift that I built for the hardtop, because we get triple digit weather, and as you can see, sunny, beautiful, why not take that top off? So. Here we go. She's a 2005 Jeep Wrangler TJ Unlimited. And I got it at probably about 90, maybe 80,000 miles. Don't remember. It's been about a year now. We've done a few upgrades. So we got the transmission rebuilt. If you guys have ever had those straight sixes, straight six 4.0 bulletproof engine, really not a lot to go wrong with that. But the transmission, if you guys don't get that manual transmission, the Jeep does have some problems on that. I believe it's like a 42 RL something. Anyways, it was a Chrysler transmission that they used in a lot of like minivans. I believe the Dakotas had it and the Grand Caravans. They discontinued that transmission just because it had those problems. So when I first got the Jeep, the transmission overheated, ate out the clutch packs, had to get the whole thing rebuilt. Solved it with the transmission oil cooler line. So if you guys ever have to do that, definitely an upgrade to this thing. But you could always just go manual and you wouldn't have that problem. So it's got 33s, BFGs. The spare that it came with was the Patagonia MT. That's a 33 as well. So that spare is going to actually be useful. Unlike most Jeeps that upgrade their four tires, never upgrade the fifth. These tires have 5/32 of tread left in it. So we're getting close to replacing them. I don't really want to get the BF Goodriches again, only because of how expensive they are. They're a really good tire, but doing the rotates on customers' cars, the BF Goodriches, especially the mud terrains, they have a lot of uneven wear. The all terrains is what I'm running, and I love them. They're not loud, never let me down in the snow. But we're going to try and switch it up and go with the Patagonias. Obviously, it's covered, but this is a mud terrain spare. I had a customer come in the other day, and they had all four of those with the Patagonias. Didn't have the spare, but driving it around, I really liked it. Not a lot of sound, pretty comfortable. So we'll do another YouTube video on that when I install those and just do a review on that altogether. So today we're gonna be doing the hardtop. So I've got this Smittybilt bikini top with a header channel. It's nothing too crazy. I mean, it really beats taking the hardtop off and just sitting there underneath. So I give it probably maybe 3 out of 5 stars over craftsmanship, because like this tends to get loose, so I do my knots on that, keep it in tight. And the back end portion, if you don't have anything retaining these straps, because it's just these little buckles here, this gets loose on the highway at about 50 miles an hour and the flapping's just annoying. So definitely recommend getting some sort of retainer like this. So I just got a ratcheting strap, does the job just fine. And it works. So I've had the top off now for probably about a week. And, you know, it's cool, but it's been getting hotter and hotter. And I'd like to wash the car. As you can see, it's been dirty for the last couple weekends. And that's just because every weekend we're up in Big Bear. So what I got here is not the stock hardtop. This is a Wild Boar fastback hardtop. The reason why I got this one was mainly because it was cheap. So I paid $400 for this. If you look, it has a sunroof. It's pretty cool. But it didn't have the back glass. So what I had to do was I learned how to weld in 30 minutes and went ahead and did a frame here just so it was a little bit reinforced. Put some plexiglass on that, used rivets to hold it in. And then I went ahead and just got some camper shell locks just so people couldn't open it. But we did mess up on the cut here. So I'm going to go back and probably insulate everything with rubber. If not, find a piece of glass suitable for replacing this. This is an aftermarket top. That company unfortunately went out of business. From what I've learned, it didn't work out too much, but you will see these on the trail still. They are a good hardtop, which is why I don't understand why they went out of business. So the sunroof's cool, it leaks. So I don't even bother opening it. Put some flex seal, and yes, that works. Has not leaked since. So one of the main problems that I faced was taking this hardtop off. I used to have to call my brother, he'd have to come over and we'd have to lift it together, and it would take 2, maybe 3 guys. It was just kind of a pain. So in order to fix that problem, I thought, well, hey, we can either drill some holes, put some handles on this hardtop. That might've worked out, but I was worried about the integrity of the hardtop, because the hardtop does have a crack in it already. So that labor and just that pressure, I didn't want anything to happen with the hardtop. So I decided to go ahead and try something new. So what I went ahead and did was I got a couple 2x4s, nothing too expensive. Put some eyelets there, and of course got some ratcheting straps with eyelets up to the rack.
If you're lucky enough that you have a garage, this is really something simple to do. I think it took me maybe 20 minutes to do everything and cost me about at the most $35 in labor. You could get something similar to this online and it would run you probably about.
So when you try and back the car in, the spare tends to hit here. So sometimes it's a two-person job. My girlfriend will come in, back up the car, and I will have to lift this. But this honestly takes up a lot of the weight distribution. So I am able to lift one edge with my shoulder and it's fine. So that's not a big problem. Just a little annoying if you do plan on doing this by yourself, driving it in, lowering it down. I would suggest a taller garage. As it is, a Jeep just barely squeezes in here, and that is why I won't be going to 35s anytime soon. All right, so we'll go ahead and lower it down and I will show you everything that you're gonna need to bolt it back up. Really isn't much.
Yet we had that engine running just like a song. Now the headlights, there was another sight. We had two on the left and one on the right. But when we pulled out the switch, all three of them come on. The back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together, and when we got through, well, that's when we noticed that we only had one tail fin. About that time, my wife walked out and I could see in her eyes that she had her tail.
Right. So that process took maybe about 10, 15 minutes. But I got a smaller garage, so it probably would have been a little bit quicker if I had a little bit more space to work with. So what I did when I was messing around with this area of the hardtop, I was trying to center it correctly, because the first time I got this top, it was warped. It had been sitting out in someone's backyard for, I think, a year or two, he said. So the doors before weren't closing. Like right there, you can see where it hits. So it's just a matter of kind of giving a little bit of a push. But even then, it's not going to sit completely flush. And when I got the top, the little latches up here were broken. So I went to Great Tops and they had those. And let's see if I can get it. Yeah. So it's just these little latches. You can adjust them in and out, push it in. And there you go. It's just like a regular stock talk Jeep. So everything zooms correctly, minus this crappy wiring for the sunscreen. But yeah, after that's all complete, there's gonna be three holes, one, two, and number three is on the other side of this pillar. You could use an impact with a swivel. I prefer not to, because then you just stress out the bolts too much. And again, the top is fiberglass, so it's just contact points that could potentially cause cracking or crushing of the material. So I try not to. Use a 13 or a half inch, and basically just a couple lock washers, flat washer, and you got this funny looking nut here that just lies on the bottom and just kind of screws in and out. So the top came with the hinges, came with the hardware for all this, and this is what we got. But the problem with this, because the plexiglass is just, it's too brittle, is you can't have both of them on at the same time. So when I have to put the window down, I have to unclip one of these from here just so it doesn't crack like it did the first time when I tried it out. Other than that, it's a pretty good top. We take it up in the snow, we take it up in the rain, we take it up in the mud. Doesn't get that bad. Well, doesn't get anything at all. So it didn't get too dirty in here. But yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and bolt those up and we'll be good to go. Thanks for watching. Go ahead and subscribe, comment. Any suggestions, I really would appreciate it.